Bruins when facing elimination for the Boston Bruins. Obviously, they have not been eliminated, so we don't need to worry about the record there. But the goals, it's 14 goals and just 4 goals allowed. Their power placement so good throughout the playoffs, and that PK has been absolutely dominant as well. Dano, we talk about dominance, and I think that if we discuss the Boston Bruins during the regular season, often it was about the top line. Early on in the playoffs, it was often about the top line, but also about the depth. Now we go into Game 6 on Sunday, Game 7 on Wednesday. How important is that top line?
It's huge. And obviously, throughout these playoffs, when the proverbial backs are against the wall, their big guns have stepped up. That, we always talk about experience. That's the experience and pedigree and savvy of the Boston Bruins. And oh yeah, the experienced guys are highly skilled. Quick release from Marchand. This is a sharp angle. I know it's a 5-on-3 for the Bruins, but earlier in this series, that puck might have been right in the pants. But Game 6, their season on the line, Marchand focused, knew exactly where he was going to put that puck, and the release just didn't allow Binnington to get across. He got things going for the Bruins. David Pastrnak, you know, he's been up and down. A lot of scorers are, as far as they're not going to score every night, not going to create every night. And some teams are focused. Certainly the Blues have been. They haven't done much 5-on-5. They've done a real good job in these top guys. But Pastrnak steps up and shows his great hands in front of the net. And that's when the Bruins started to really roll. They took this game over as far as not needing as many opportunities. I mean, you know, I heard it was a pretty evenly played game, and it was for large parts 5-on-5. That's the difference in the Bruins' experience and finish around the net. And these guys know anytime, they're questioned, and a lot of times, what's wrong when they didn't score for 2 games and haven't had a 5-on-5 point? What's wrong with Bergeron, Marchand, and Pastrnak? Well, they'll tell you what's wrong. Game wasn't on the, our season wasn't quite on the line yet, but we're going to go get it done. And they certainly did that in Game 6. And Tuukka Rask in the net, he was the one that gave them a chance, because the Blues tried to end the game in the first 6 minutes. They were all over them, had opportunities, couldn't capitalize on their power play. It's amazing. Think about this. The Blues are in this series going to a Game 7, so they got to look at the positives, the fact that they've scored 1 goal out of 18 attempts on the power play. The Bruins have scored 7 for 23, I believe it is. I mean, just think of that. We talk about the importance of special teams. Bruins have dominated the special teams. That shows you how well the Blues have been able to shut those top guys down 5-on-5 at times. But last night, Game 6, they were going to have none of it. And this is going to be an epic Game 7, because we're going to see what gives here.
Something has to give. And it's funny, you brought up all those numbers. And I'm a bit of a stat nerd at times, and I love going through the numbers. But really, you can kind of almost throw those stats out and say it's going to be done out there. You and I were sitting here on Sunday at this desk watching this game. Jake DeBrusk stood out to you. Yeah. Why?
This time of year, we always talk about it. Every team, they say the right things, but desperation. I didn't see as much desperation out of the Bruins in Game 5. Well, look at Jake DeBrusk. Not known to be a real sound defensive player, but look what he's doing. Blocks the first shot with his leg, dives, gets a piece of that second shot with his stick. Everybody paying the price this time of year. That was the difference, and sometimes that's all it takes in big games, is who's got a little more desperation level? Who's a little higher? I thought the Bruins, after the surge from the Blues in the first 6 minutes of the first period, had the little more the edge in that desperation factor in all 3 zones. Whereas in Game 5, even though the Bruins outshot them heavily, I thought the Blues had that desperation factor at important key times of the game. That's what the Bruins did in Game 6. And it was a prime example. Jake DeBrusk right there. I'm not saying he's bad defensively, but he's just learning along the way. But you see how he goes down, blocks the shot. He might not be doing that in the regular season. But he knew, I have to do whatever it takes to help this team win. He's known as an offensive player. He's known as a sniper. Well, he's in his own zone making 2 terrific plays there, not letting pucks get through. And that's why both these teams are here. That's why we're having a Game 7, because they've got depth and they've got guys stepping out of their comfort zone and doing other things if they're not scoring, if they're known as an offensive player, like Jake DeBrusk did just there.